Do you guys get that hit of dopamine every time you see a yellow number pop up whenever you deal damage in Wartales? Yeah, I do too. So, what exactly is the math behind that magical yellow number, and why does it make us feel so good? In this video, we're going to look into just that. What's going on, everybody? This is Clydean Fair. Let's talk about Wartales crit versus raw damage stat debate edition. So, I know I've had multiple questions pop up just in the YouTube comments of my attributes video where I went over crit being better than raw damage stats in a theoretical standpoint, and I hadn't actually done the math for it. And this has also led to multiple discussions in the Wartales official Discord talking about the differences between pumping crit versus pumping your raw damage stats and where the discrepancy is. And this led to a lot of different people doing their own damage stat calculators, and quite frankly, I just wasn't a huge fan of how many variables there were. So it kind of led to me doing this video where I went in and pulled all the information I possibly could from the actual data. So not just in-game testing, but opening up the game's code and figuring out where the math formulas are. Special shout out to Dorim for helping me dig through a lot of these formulas while he was working on making mods. I'm going to go ahead and make sure that he has access to these charts and spreadsheets as well, so you will be able to see all of this information in his guide, which will be linked below. Once I grabbed all these formulas, I went ahead and started doing the math and put them into a nice pretty spreadsheet, and we're going to get to that later. This spreadsheet quite literally took me multiple days to get put together to figure out all the math and formulas in it and finally get all the graphs popped up. Is this going to be an all-inclusive presentation? No, because I don't like making super long videos, so we're going to try and get through this as quickly as possible while still giving you guys the information that you need to understand where the point is in the game where crit starts to outscale damage stats. Anyway, getting into it, we had to figure out what the base growth stats for each character is. Now, mind you, there's actually only three character types in this game. There is heavy armor strength units, there are medium armor strength units, and then there are dexterity units. All of them have the exact same potential growth stats across the board. So your archers and your rangers will have the exact same growth stat. Your spearmen and your medium armor brute swordsmen and warriors will all have the exact same base growth stats. Then we had to go in and start figuring out the differences between stats on weapons. And then you start to realize that all white weapons are the same if they're all the same weapon type. So a one-handed mace, a one-handed axe, a one-handed sword, if they're all white, they're all the exact same stat. They're all white and all have the exact same quality score. So no stars, they'll all have the same stat. If they all have the same stars, they'll all have the same stat. This is how this works. And this is true across every single point in the game. A one-handed mace versus a one-handed axe, whether it is a level 12 purple item or a level 6 blue item, if they match in rarity, level, and star level, they will always have the exact same stats. So that's something we had to go in, keep in mind. Same thing between two-handed weapons, between strength users. And we also had to keep in mind that Dex has its own unique stat pool. So your daggers and your bows will always have the exact same stats, assuming that they have, once again, the same level, rarity, and quality. So we had to put all of this into a spreadsheet, of course, and figure out what those actual stat numbers are. And there's going to be a graph going over what the scaling is, essentially, on the different weapons and the stats. And you will start realizing that there is quite a bit of a jump where things start to grow exponentially around level 8 and 9. And this also coincides with the fact that most people feel like the game starts getting to easy mode around level 8 and 9. This pattern is just now starting, but it's going to keep on going. Anyway, now that we've gone and covered all of our base stat growths between weapons and classes, let's go ahead and get on into the math. So one of the challenges that we had trying to figure out the math on this is we had to figure out exactly what the return ratio is between strength points to critical damage and dex points and critical chance. And it turns out that this is hidden in the code. It's not easy to find out if you don't depack the game and actually look for it. And it's essentially your dexterity to the power of 0.6 is equivalent to your bonus critical hit chance from dexterity. Coincidentally, this is the exact same math that's used for strength bonus to critical damage, except your dexterity applies to critical hit chance and your strength applies to critical damage. Critical damage has a base set of 25% before strength starts getting added to it. Critical hit chance technically has a base of zero, but because all units as of 1.0 start out with 10 willpower, they gain one critical hit chance from willpower. So it's really 1% base crit hit plus your dex modifier before adding in attributes or professions or armor slots or basically anything else. This is how the raw math goes. Moving on from how the critical damage and critical hit chance math goes into effect, we need to calculate how damage, or rather average damage, goes into the game. Your average damage is essentially going to be dependent on what weapon you are wielding. Each weapon has a different minimum damage and maximum damage output. So, for example, a weapon like Lucia, which is a two-handed legendary mace that you can get in Tiltrin, if you use this, you will always do 135% of your strength damage to any enemy that is in the arc. This is what I refer to as a flat percent, because it doesn't have a range of damage. Whenever you crit with a flat percent weapon, you deal your flat percent damage plus your critical damage modifier. And that is actually really simple, easy math. But where do things start getting weird? Well, things start getting weird when you actually have a damage spread. You see, if you have a 10% damage spread, on average, you will do somewhere in the middle. And by middle, I mean literally in the middle. So for example, in this spreadsheet, we're going to be using a calculation between 70 and 80%, because 80% is one of the most common damage percentages in the game. So we did a range of 70% to 80%. So on average, a regular hit will do 75% damage between, you know, 100 hits. So where do crits come into play? Well, crits deal the maximum damage range plus critical damage modifier. So you're going to slowly see, as the range of damage increases, the amount of average damage increases as your crit goes up. If your crit does not go up and you instead put points into your strength or dexterity stat, then it will continue to go up, obviously, but not quite as much as if you had dumped everything into crit. And this really doesn't become apparent until around levels 9 or 10 for the most part. So at this point, we're gonna go ahead and start looking at how all these graphs align next to each other and really dig into exactly where everything seems to go out of whack and where crit will start to outscale raw damage stats. Now, let this be known that this is simply showing you guys the math, and it's actually kind of eye-opening because it shows that honestly, while crit at max level will outscale your standard damage output, if you just pump everything into your raw damage stat, it doesn't outscale it nearly as much as you would think. And quite frankly, it is kind of disappointing when you realize how many levels of stat points you put into things. So, for example, we're going to take a look at a one-handed heavy armor user compared across three different weapons: a flat percent weapon, a 20% damage spread weapon, and a 40% damage spread weapon. So this will give us an idea of exactly how all of these weapons will scale based off of using strength or crit, considering this is a heavy armor user. And on top of that, all of these weapons that are in consideration right now are essentially going to be of equivalent power of a purple item. Now, before we start getting too far into these charts, the math behind all of these charts assume that you're using a purple weapon as well as using the highest level weapon that you can possibly wear at that character level. So essentially, if you're level 1, you're using a level 2 purple weapon. If you're level 3, you're using a level 4 purple weapon, so on and so forth. Now, I understand that this isn't going to necessarily show a realistic level 1 damage output, but it will be really close if you're level 1 and you have a yellow weapon, because purple and yellow weapon stats are basically identical at levels 1, 2, and maybe even 3, and then things start to scale a little bit differently. But anyway, as we look at the one-handed heavy armor flat weapon graph, and it seems that really crit's not going to outscale strength until almost level 11, if not level 12. And while this graph can definitely be edited a little bit if you accounted for professions, and the crossover will go a little bit to the right if you choose something like blacksmith, but it will go a little bit to the left if you choose something like tinkerer. To be honest, it's so far late into the game that unless you're really trying to have the maximum damage output at level 12, it's not really worth it for you to pump this many points into critical hit. So at level 11 is when the crossover is, so you would essentially have 10 levels of critical hit chance added in. So that's essentially a 20% bonus to critical hit. If you can somehow get 20 points of critical hit earlier, then you're going to see that you're outscaling. So that's another reason why I wanted to do the graphs, is that you can see exactly what level of attribute points you would need and start seeing these gaps a little bit quicker. And this is going to be a useful tool for you guys in the future as well. And then as we take a look at the 20% one-handed heavy armor user, obviously this starts to shift a little bit further to the left. And at this point, it's barely past level 10, so you won't quite see the overtaking of crit versus strength in this scenario until you are level 11, even with a 20% weapon. But as we go to a 40% weapon, it happens right before level 10, so you will see that crit starts to take over at level 10 whenever you allocate those points. That being said, though, let's go ahead and take a look at how a medium armor user is going to go. And we're going to just start speeding this up a little bit and explaining how each graph kind of displays where all of these overtaking points are and how you can change your allocation points as you level up to tweak these results a little bit quicker for you. And you'll be able to see that things really do start to outscale a little bit quicker with crit if you put someone into an angler or a tinkerer, or a little bit later if you put something into, oh, let's say a alchemist or a blacksmith. So for the three weapon types we're going to cover for a one-handed medium armor user, you are going to roughly hit on a flat percent around level 11. On a 20%, you're going to be right around level 11. And then at a 40%, you're going to be around level 10. Now, this is where things are going to take a little bit of a turn, because we're going to start covering a dex weapon on this next set of graphs. And dex doesn't scale into critical damage. It scales into critical hit chance, which is slightly different. So we're going to go ahead and make sure that we cover this correctly. So dex, because you get to consistently crit more because you have so much dex with these weapons, you're going to see that these scale even further to the left because you're dealing more consistent damage. Even on a flat percent weapon, you are going to be overtaking with a crit build at level 9. And at a 20% weapon, you're still going to be overtaking at level 9. Now, instead of a 40% weapon, we went ahead and did a 50% weapon because there are bows in the game that have a 50% damage spread, and I really wanted to make sure that I covered this random outlier because dex has a very wide damage spread on bows. And at a 50%, crit overtakes raw dex stat at level 8. And of course, we're going to go ahead and make sure that we show some love to the two-handed weapons for our strength users. So we're going to go ahead and cover those as well. First things first, we're going to cover heavy armor two-handed users. On a flat two-handed weapon and heavy armor, crit will overtake strength around level 10. And then when you get to a 20% two-handed heavy armor user, it ends up being right around level 9 exactly. And then finally for a 40% user, so it's going to be level 9, assuming you're not getting any of these confessions that give you bonus aptitude points or anything like that. And then finally, we're going to go ahead and get into the main DPS units that you're going to have for strength weapons, which are going to be medium armor two-handed user strength weapons. So for a flat percent two-handed weapon user, crit's going to outscale your raw strength damage around level 10. I know it looks earlier, but it's really still after level 9, so I just had to make sure that I said it was level 10. On a 20% two-handed medium armor user, crit will start outscaling at level 9, and then for a 40% two-handed medium armor user, crit will start outscaling right around level 8. Anyway, guys, there was a ton of work that went into this video behind the scenes. I know that editing style and recording wise, it's probably not going to seem that extravagant, but there was a ton of math work that went on behind the scenes here. And I hope this gives you a better idea on where you can start to see more returns from investing into critical hit chance or investing into your raw damage stats, such as strength or dexterity. And it also gives you a better idea on where to allocate professions, because you can use these professions to give you bonus stats into critical hit chance or your raw damage stat to really give you a boost to where you're going to see those damage spikes a little bit earlier. Anyway, guys, that's all I've got. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to see more videos such as this, like the video. Let me know if you were surprised by any of these findings in the comments and make that number go up. Until next time, have a good one.